Matching.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Ready. Yellow lady, yellow lady.
59, Mike to 59.
Throwing on first down is Breeze. Flushed out right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Brian Burns. Just would not be denied. That's a loss of seven. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. The Pro Bowler Michael Thomas was the intended receiver, and it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Breeze. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Smith. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A gain of 19 and picking up the first.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, New Orleans. Jared Cook, his fourth touchdown on the year as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. So we are in the final minute now of the first half as this offense gets ready to take over.
Ready? You ready?
Right there, 54 Mike.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now Breeze. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. K1 short with a sack. That's 315 pounds of man right there. They were trying to set up that screen, trying to get that screen to formulate. Took too long.
Ends up taking a sack, and that leads you to a couple of other questions. Number one, why don't you just get rid of the football near the screen, guy, so that you don't take an interception? But really, the big one, they just took everything away, and he was really kind of flummoxed on that play and ended up taking the sack.
Returnable here from the 38. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Panthers will take over in terrific field position. Christian McCaffrey and the Panthers about set to go on offense. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he? We pick it up second quarter here as the offense gets ready for the drive. Here's Kamara off the draw.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
Face mask penalty, and Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle, so you end up flailing away, and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
On first down, Breeze. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. It'll be a three-yard gain, and it'll make it a second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up the time.
A breakaway for Michael Thomas. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas. So we are in the second quarter now as the offense gets set to take over. They've got it first and 10. And they'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And nothing but daylight ahead. And they finally are able to take him down at the opposite 47. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. To throw, it's Breeze. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Check, 95, 56. Right here.
Throwing again on second down. Breeze. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. The safety, Ross Cockrell, there to knock that one away.
Brings up third down and 6 yards to go.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. A final shot before half for Breeze. He wants it all for the end zone. Got a man open. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for New Orleans. This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. They start the second half with Kamara. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Second and 6, just inside the 30.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Those shoulders went from parallel to square. And then he brought force with him to finish that run. Oh, that's impressive.
And we saw a lot of that a week ago when he got the NFC Offensive Player of the Week award. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. He'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Breeze now to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Thomas. He was over 100 receiving last week. He's over 100 now this week as he's got a first down as well. And he's over 100 yards now after that last catch. Already, of course, leading the NFL in receiving yardage.
So he's done nothing at all to hurt his cause to stay in that spot. But I've been so impressed with how he's gotten it done. Body control, route running. How about the way he competes for the football at the end of the play?
On second and 9, Breeze. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And now running right through it. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Breeze able to find the veteran again. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft.
Looking for Thomas. He's got him. Touchdown, New Orleans. 4 touchdown passes now for Drew Brees and the Saints. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Fighting through pressure. Shakes off the sack. But now he's swallowed up and taken down. Dontari Poe marches in for the sack.
How many times have we sat with coordinators, and especially the defensive guys, they've talked about big plays, sacks, they often come in bunches. Well, it may not be a bunch here, but that is the third sack of the game for them.
And around the sack 3 or 4, I would think, it starts to get in the quarterback's head a little bit.
Not just the quarterback, the offensive play caller, the offensive line, knocks people off balance and changes what they normally do.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. Throwing now is Breeze. And this is Cook with a grab. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion and the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Breeze now on first down. James Bradbury, he was right there to break it up.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Inside of 2 minutes remaining in a two-point ball game. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They run it for the first time with a backup Murray. Able to spin free. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. We'll likely put an end to this thing. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
He showed some tough running, but they'll drop him at the 5-yard line. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. A 10th carry for Kamara. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. And just one man in the backfield here. That's Kamara, second and goal. And they'll take a knee as the clock ticks down toward 50 seconds to go. They need to reverse the trend. The last two plays have gone backwards. Now it's third and goal. They'll go ahead and take the knee here, and the unbeaten season will continue. So this one, a victory here for New Orleans. And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just a week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it.
choppers, that's 20 goons. And ice cream whip, triple school. I got three strikes, ain't got to lose. When it's all on the line, what you gonna do? Come on, I'm highly favored. Don't wanna play me, no conversation. Ain't got time for no debating. It's for the taking, no hesitation. Don't try my patience. I'ma pour out one for the set, boy, till there's nothing left. On a run to the bread until we all got them baguettes. Hear them footsteps coming, cause we coming for the check.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Ready.
5-8, 5-8.
The first carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity.
And right away, he lost the football. And the Falcons grab it. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And this is going to be brought back. It's a scoop and score for the Falcon TD. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Running with Kamara. And he's not going anywhere to start the night. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Looking to throw on second down. Freeze. Oh, look at Thomas, wide open. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Face mask. Defense.
And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
They run on first down as they get about three. Second and seven, forthcoming. The numbers there for Kamara from a week ago. 10 carries, 125 yards.
And now that he's playing a Thursday night game, short week, you know he spent a lot of time in the trainer's room in the cold tub trying to get his legs back for this game.
He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he's going to get it down to the 14-yard line. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 14. A first opportunity upcoming in the red zone for the Saints. It's first and 10 at the 14. Here's Breeze to throw. Got a man open. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for New Orleans. So the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. They'll run. This is Kamara. Oh, fighting off the defender. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
And that run was memorable for only one reason. There's absolutely no place to run with the football. No gaps, no creases, no gain.
Over the middle to Smith. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down.
Ready.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Watch the run.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. Still going. Shrugs off another. Oh, he breaks another. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
The throw from Breeze into the hands of Smith, and he'll get it down to the 47 here. 7 yards there and a first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver because you got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone. Sometimes you're throwing it between the zones. Sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. It was Desmond Trufant right there, step for step in coverage. So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. Now Breeze again. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice game. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. That is caught inside the 5. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
Ready? 95-56, 95-56.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Breeze, that's caught at the 3. And he is going to lose yardage here. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number 1.
Set, 95-56.
Okay, just like that, just like that.
Breeze now on 3rd and goal. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Ted Ginn in the final seconds of the first. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
I'm going back to you.
Breeze now on 1st down. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
An incomplete pass on 2nd down leads us to 3rd and inches. And some room to maneuver. The 40. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara, his 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the 4th most in a single season. Now the offense back out onto the field as they'll take over here in the final minute of this 3rd quarter. They begin on the ground with Kamara. And he's got some space here. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Alvin Kamara with touchdown number 20. Now the offense back out onto the field as they'll take over here in the final minute of this 3rd quarter. Space to maneuver at the 40. And now running right through him. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara with his 28. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They'll run it now out of the gun. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. They run it again with Kamara. Fighting through it. He's got space. Through an opening, and there he goes. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Alvin Kamara with touchdown number 29. Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. Now a handoff here to his running back. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he almost made it, but just short. Finally out of bounds, right down around the goal line. A big gain there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column. And that run has to be so deflating for the defense. They needed the stop. That might put the ice. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. So now we're in the final minute of the game in the fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Mike Ready. Yellow Lady.
Mike 5-4. Focus, defense, focus.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara.
Go, go, go.
And shutting him off. Now open field. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That good for 22 and a first down. Another fine carry from the NFL's rushing leader, and quarterbacks typically dominating the MVP balloting, but I think you got to give this guy serious consideration, don't you?
I agree totally. I mean, he's leading the league in rushing, and let's face it, partner, the running back renaissance in the NFL, it's real, and it's really helping teams along the way. He's a prime example. Got to give him strong consideration for MVP talk.
Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. He'll get 3 up to midfield. The numbers there for Kamara from a week ago. Just downright unbelievable. I mean, when you amass that many yards, I don't know what else to say.
Personally, I thought it was a game for the ages for him. Ripped off some long runs in that contest, didn't he?
He did indeed. Some very long runs, and that total, scary. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
And him running the football is not something that defenses spend a lot of time preparing for. But this guy has a survival instinct and a knack for knowing when exactly to do it.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. 4 yards on the pickup. Good enough to extend the drive. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Give him 30 yards there. So now following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. Off the play fake to Kamara. Breeze to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Back to the air on second down. It's Breeze. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. But now it's third and goal.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodged two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we've just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've kind of run out of your running plays. Fire another one into the end zone.
Breeze now. And he's got it. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown.
Ready.
The offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. A first down run, good for about three. Second and seven coming up. DeForest Buckner in on the tackle. Ready for the second quarter from New Orleans. It's the Saints in possession as they've got it second and seven. Ready for the second quarter from New Orleans. It's the Saints in possession. Kamara as they've got it second and seven. A big seam and he might go all the way. 30. And he's in for the score, and his spectacular season continues as he ties the NFL touchdown record.
He is phenomenal.
And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again.
So we are in the final minute now of the first half as this offense gets ready to take over. Now a play fake here on first down. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Second and 10 now from the 27. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And another tackle broken. A big play there out of Kamara. 59 yards for him on the ground. Well, this is the reigning NFC Offensive Player of the Week. Runs like that might get him another award.
Yeah, Thunderbolt right out of the gate, huh? How about that? Hitting the defense hard early. And, of course, carrying the momentum from last week into this week's game.
And he'll get about three just outside the 10, stopped at the 11. Not quite the success they had last play. This one goes for 3 yards. On second down, Kamara. He showed some tough running, but they'll drop him at the 5-yard line. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing.
And
we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for three and not giving up six.
The kick by Lutz is good, and the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they could. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to...